Hey guys, Thatnub here, and today we are going to be assembling the NP101267 aero metal storage shed. This is a 10x12 metal storage shed, and we are going to use this to put all of our stuff in while we are living in the trailer. It came in yonder box over there, which was very heavy. Two people kind of pushed it into the Explorer and it weighed it down. That's a heavy box. But we got it out here and put it out in this kind of clearing, well, after we cleared it. And like there's roof pieces over there and there's some wall pieces and whatnot and all these pieces around here. And we also have the flooring kit that came with it. This is just a temporary thing, so I'm not going to do anything fancy like leveling it or lifting it or putting a cement pad underneath it. So do those things if you want to. I'm not going to do it. So we got the floor kit down and then realized that we actually needed to put step one in first. So we're going to do this by the numbers, try to make this in one video. And it seems pretty self-explanatory, but there's just no videos online about this getting assembled yet. It's kind of like, here's all the pieces, and then boom, it's up, and wow, that was hard. So we're gonna see how hard it is together. First thing we're gonna need on this border is three pieces. Two of them are 9, 3, 6, 7, and one of them is, what is this here? 8, 9, 3, 4. And you can see here that there are drainage holes right there and there and probably one here, and those have to be facing the outside of the storage shed, I guess. So we're going to put those on, and this one here, the 9367, put it, I think, with this way facing kind of out. Now there are on that piece these little holes here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and here are some bigger holes, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we are going to use these screws. Here we go, focus, and screw them in. When you are done, you should have four screws there, and my assistant over here is finishing up his four screws right now, and we'll go through step two. Step two shows us using 10392, two of those, and that's the side floor frame. It's supposed to measure out to 141 5/8 inches, so that's how you find out if it's right. But I'm just going to show you right now that we have that number right there, 10392. And here, zoom out a bit, there we go. You can see there's one of the holes there, there's one of the holes there, there's one of the holes there, and one of the holes there. And up here you can see two tabs. This one here will be open, and this one here will be closed by the bottom piece. Put this over so you guys can see that. See, here is the other opening right there, but it's covered up. And 1, 2, 3, 4 holes. So what you do is you're going to take this bag of screws here. 1, 2, 3, 4, plus some. That's the thing I love about this kit. Check this bag out. This is perfect for me. The extra parts and clothes are provided for your convenience. Yeah, I'm gonna need some of those. Okay, so we're gonna take one of those, and we're gonna put them in here, right there. And then we're gonna flip it for the other side, because here it shows us using one down, and then one coming up, and then on the other side, one coming down and one coming up. So we're gonna do that for this. Here's what it's gonna look like when you're done. We have one here with the nut on that side, and here's the nut on that side, and there's a screw, and there's the nut coming up there. And that is one side complete. Now let's do the next one. Next part of step two is using two of the 8936 rear floor frames. Should measure out to 119 inches when you're done, or look, something. See, there's, oh, there it is right there. Boop. And it should look joined together right here. So we have one, two, where you can see through, and then three, four, and there's a hole in the middle that will line up perfectly. And down here, you can see the same thing. So there's one, two, three, four, and then the hole in the middle. And then we're gonna put the screws in the same way that we did the last time. One up, one down, one up, one down. And when you're done, one, two, three, four, tightened up, nice and tight. On to the next page, page 15. We are on step two, and step one and two of step two is to take those numbers there and put them together. So what you're gonna do is, there's a long end and a short end, and the long end goes on top, short end goes on the bottom, all the way down the whole thing. And right here, oops, long ends cross and the short ends bud together. Then you will, from this side down, eight screws there and eight nuts there, and tighten them up. Do that for both of them. You'll come with two beams. After you do 10 389, we're going to do 10 390, and this is the sidewall channels. They're going to make two of these right here, make two sidewall channels. So we're going to do this same thing twice, and your end result is going to look like this. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 on the top, and 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 on the bottom. And you're going to use the bolt and the nut to accomplish that. When you do this, you're going to have the long piece. See down here, there's a shorter end and a longer end. So let's say the longer end is going to be your top, let's say. So when you bring it down here, your two longer ends are going to overlap, and your two shorter ends are going to bud right up to each other. And that's how you know where it's the right spot. And then do two of those, and we'll go to the next step. Now we're going to take two of the 10 392s and connect them for the side floor frame. And we're going to do this twice because there's going to be a right and a left side. So when you do that, we're going to use a bolt and a nut, and we're going to connect them thusly. One facing down, one facing up, one facing down, one facing up, vice versa. There's holes here on the side that should line up, two there and two here, to be used later for something, I'm sure. And you're gonna see, if you look underneath here, there's gonna be two tabs and one, or two, slots for tab things here. And same thing on the top, two slots. And only one of them is going to show through, the other one is not. So it's gonna be one filled and one completely open. And to measure this out, the side floor frame should measure out to 141 inches from, and 5/8 from this little tip there all the way down to the other end tip down there, the longest points. It'll measure out to that when you have it right. Do two of those and we'll go on to the next stop. We are on to number three on page 15. And it says to overlap the rear wall angle pieces as shown in the figure, put one bolt in the center hole. So you can see that there are five holes here, and it has one bolt going from one, just connecting the two together, of the 5986. And that will look like this. So we have one, two, three, four, five holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 holes. Connect these two together with one bolt. And if we need another one right here later on, I'm sure we'll be told to do that later on. But this is going to go on the top part to hold the tops of the walls. Now we're going to take the 10'393 pieces, there should be four of them, and we're going to make two wall angles by connecting one screw through the only hole that there is on it. And there is no hole on that end, only a hole on that end, so you really can't mess this up. When you're done, it should look like this. One hole, just one screw on each one. We'll make really two really long pieces. And these are four side somethings. On to page 16, step three, we're gonna take two of the 10'568 pieces. We're gonna force them together. Basically, see, it says these pieces are force fitted, so you may have to press hard to join them together. And we're gonna place it to where the six holes align. So here we have on one end, the end with that piece. We're gonna take that and that one where it's kind of cut there and it's kind of cut here like we did before. We're gonna take these six holes and align them with those six holes. So we're gonna take this piece and put it in kind of like that, and we're gonna rotate it in until it fits. So my partner is gonna show us how to do that right now. Something like that. Now we have all six holes aligned up, and we will take nothing. We will do nothing. Right here at the bottom it says do not insert bolts yet. So grab the other two that you have and do the same thing. With the next step, it took me about 5 minutes of rereading this instruction to figure out what they were talking about. Basically, you take two of the pieces that you just made and you join them together to make this kind of like a T hangman kind of whatever it is thing. And what you're going to do is you're going to take the backs of both of the pieces and push them together, and down here, right about there, down here is going to be the flat piece right here. So we have this flat piece, the eye that goes up, and the T that here comes down, and over here comes down. And we're going to fasten those two together. So after you kind of squish them together, what you're going to do is you're going to take two bolts and put it through here, six here, and two here. So we're going to put two right here, and where do they meet up here? Oh, there we go. Six there, and then two way down there. And seal this thing all the way up. When we bolted these together, the bottoms fit just fine, but the top pieces here wouldn't go together because we put this top piece and this top piece together, and the bolt has to go all the way through, and there was this gap. And so these little bolts would not fit all the way through that gap. So what we're going to try to do is take and make this part here on top and this part here be on the inside and see if that helps fix our issue. So what we ended up doing was putting both ends on the inside and leaving this out. The other side here lined up perfectly, so we were just able to bolt those in. This side though still doesn't give us enough room for this to get through all of it. So we are going to take these, clamp it on, and squeeze down as we tighten a bolt in. So when you're putting this one here in, you want this as close to that as possible. Squish it down. Same thing here, same thing here. We started off with the middle one, and then went and did that one, and then this one here was last. And as you can see, it is all nice and flat now. As soon as we tighten them all the way down, these holes here should completely line up for something I'm sure we're going to need them for later. Step three of this is to connect same thing that you did there, but don't join the two pieces together, just 6 bolts in the two pieces and have two of them. So you're gonna have two of those and one of these. And that's for the center, and this is for like the left side, and that one's for the right side. And these are the assembly beams for the roof. When you're done, it will look like this. So we have one piece overlaid on top of the other. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bolts we put. The round ends on the outside just because it's the way we did it. In here, one piece, and then again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and just connect them the same way that you did the other one. Force this side in. You might have trouble getting this bolt here in, but after you tighten down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it kind of makes it a lot easier to get that last one. If not, grab these again and just crunk, and it'll go in just fine. Now we're on to page 17, where we're going to do some door tracks. And it says, insert 4 screws from the other side only, holes on the top side of the track assembly for fastening the gable to the top of the front wall in a later step, so we won't do that now. We need 2 of the 9366 and 1 of the 6403. This here is the one you need 2 of, and this one here is painted. This is the 6403, first painted piece that we have. Down here on the one side of it, you'll see one hole, 2, 3, and then a 4th hole there. There are the 4 screw holes that we're going to use. Right in between these 2 holes here is where these are going to meet up at. Now, one side here is completely straight, and this side here is straight, and then it comes out a little bit. On these pieces, there is a bigger overlip and a smaller overlip. The smaller piece goes tucked into the bottom piece here, and this bigger piece gets tucked into there, and they will fit in just kind of like that, and then squish it in. And you'll see here, screw holes kind of line up. We do over here more because we already pushed them. And then it will kind of look like this. Little piece hanging out there. This comes up right in the middle, meets together, and goes down with more of it hanging out the end there. For this step, you're going to need 4 of these screws. And you can see there's one in there. One here, there, and one down there. Now this piece is done. This piece, 66769, looks like this and is in your bag of parts. And according to here, the long top edge of this that we just did is the top, and the short part is the bottom. And these slide in this way. You see, contrast. So there's a straight part and a curved part, and the curved part is the bottom, and the straight part is the top. And here is the longer piece and the shorter piece. And this would go in like that. And then the next one. And these hold the doors, 2 on this side, 2 down the other side. And it says to put them on now and to keep them there for later use, but I know that I'm going to lose these, and since I'm the foreman of this build, I'm putting them back in the bag until we need them. Page 18, we start putting the floor frame together. And step 1 is basically saying to take, 10392 that we put together earlier, and 8936 that we put together earlier, and use the tap screws, or whatever these screws here are. Screw in focus, these, and put the 10392 on top of the 8936 and screw them into the little holes on the corners, and they kind of look like that. And then on the front, we're going to take 10392 and put it on top of 9367, and this one gets two of those same screws, but it also gets a bolt put from the bottom up and the nut put into the little center cavity. And since that's the end I'm sitting at, that's what we're going to show you. So you can see here how that was done, and then here are the two tap screws there. Now here I put like it said into here, at least I think this is what it's trying to say, is a 392 on top of 9367. So this one here is the 392. So I put that on top of there, even though this one is really on top of that one underneath. So I don't know if that makes sense to anybody. But you can see here, thank you, whoops, finger. This one here is the 392, long piece that goes that way. And you can see right here that it's laying on top of that. But up here, it's, I don't know, just put it together. So then when you're done, you're going to have your front piece, your corner bolted together, right side all the way down, and then your back corner done, and then do the same thing for your other side. It is a new day, so we are going to step six. And the first thing we have to do is put a corner piece onto the frame. It's going to be white on the outside, and it's going to have this little lip here for the corner part. The wide part, or the longer part, goes on the wide side. So there's our back, there's our, I'm going to say, right side, here's our front. So that little piece there goes on the narrow side, which is going to be the front and the back. And then we have to get four screws and screw them in right, where's my screw holes? There's a screw hole there, and there's a screw hole there. So we have to put in four screws there. And each screw will have a washer with it. Okay, so put those four screws in. Everybody hold the panel up while you do it. Here you see the screw in with the washer. So this side here is another one. There's another one, and one more right there. This side is done. Now we have to put the front wall, which is going to be this piece here, and its number is 9374.33, and that piece is going to go here, something like that. In the front. So we have the wall here, that's the corner piece. Here's the front wall, and they are kind of being held up on their own. We have the screws in right here. So the front piece goes over top of the corner piece. And then washer screw all the way through. Now for here, we used a bolt because the hole is about that size all the way through, and those little tap screws weren't gonna do anything except for just sit there. So for now we have a bolt on the middle one, and then down here in the corner We have the bolt and screw. There's a second bolt and screw. Third and fourth. This one over here, we did anyway, but you're supposed to leave that open. We just did it because we weren't reading the instructions right. So we'll leave that for now. But another piece goes in there. So when you're done, it should look like this. This is the front piece here, and that goes over top of the corner piece. You can see here the screw with the washer. Goes all the way down. We have two here. There's one, there's two, three, and four. Leave that one there open for the next piece. And when you're done, you should have that corner, and this corner all done. And we will be ready for putting the supports in across. Step 7 is to put the rear channel and side channels on to support the walls. The rear one is 389. This is one of the ones you put together before with all the screws. And we're going to put it right along here with some screws. Okay, for the next step, we're going to put that support rail in to the rear. And that number is the 10'389". There's one of them. And that goes, attaches to the back panels here. There are four screws that go in. And they go into little holes, like these guys, to tap holes. And then here you can see where that bolt was from the last one in the middle, and there's nothing that can go through there, so that's just where that's just gonna be. Then we're gonna take the side rails. I think that's a 10'390". We're gonna place them right here. These get bolts through them, and then they get screwed in along the side. When you're done, this is what it's gonna look like. There's our first corner that we did. There's the one bar that goes across, screwed in four times. Screws coming in from this way, washers on them, coming through. Over here, same thing, just, you know, coming from that side. Here, same thing, except here's where we overlap the two, and then I just put the four bolts in, even though the instructions really only showed two. If I have to take two out later, I'll do that. And then the same thing right here. So now we have our corners up, and they're sturdy, supported by those beams. So we will go on to step 8. Step 8. We're going to take the rear wall angle and screw it inside the top of the rear wall using screws. It's going to go back there, and there you can see the number of it, and it's going to go like that with it on the inside of the wall. So here is our 5986. And it is going to go like this. So there's our wall. That's how it's going to go. And it's going to get screwed in where it gets screwed in, right there. Those holes there, and those holes there with screws. Starting from corner number one, this is the inside. We put this on the top, and this here on the bottom, right here of that lip. There's your four screws. Same thing over here. And the reason why we did that one on top over there is because in the instructions it says that this side here has to be above the rear, right there in that gap. So we did that. When you're done, you'll have all four of these up. Now this one here, as part of, this is the 9366. This is that one we did before, and you can see how it lines up there. This is the spot for your doors to hang and slide back and forth on. So that is all of step 8. Well, one other thing to note, this goes on the inside. The track is on the inside. And it said that the holes must be on the top. So we put these holes here on the top. And make sure that you can take these out like we did before to put them back in. Before you screw it all together, you have to take it all apart again. We have the walls up now. You can see all the way around. Things to note. Here in the back, in the rear, in the middle, there is that one bolt that was here. There is an opening here that goes all the way through. Put a bolt through those. If you're having trouble getting those through, take a screw, push it through. That should make the hole a little bit better for you. Let's see. Out here, we just did an overlap. So we left this one, and then we put the new one overlapping that. Down here, the new one overlapping that. Down here, the new one overlapping that, all the way around. Make sure you put a screw in here, in these little ridges here and down at the bottom, but the instructions say nothing goes here. Step 10, you're going to need 9365. That is right here, 9365, and it looks, I don't know, about that big. You need two of those, and then you're going to need 9370, and that is this big brown flat that goes basically here. So that is what it looks like. These little pieces here go in with the flat side against the wall. You put your 1, 2, 3 screws in here, leave these two out. Do the same thing on that side. Then here we have this piece. You put 2 screws in. This is a bolt coming from in here. Then it gets a nut put on it, and then that kind of dummy end bolt. Don't wrench down too hard on those. That piece there, the round part, just popped off on one of ours. And then here just gets regular screw with the washer. Here gets the other bolt and nut. And same thing over here as, you know, the 2 screws and washers. So that is what it should look like on both sides. The one with the dummy, 2, one with the dummy, which ours doesn't have one on that side, and then the 2 down there. Step 11, we are going to take the gable and the plastic trim pieces and put it on the angled portion of the gable. There are 4 of the gable pieces, 2 left, 2 right. They don't really say left or right on them, but you'll figure it out. And the 2 for each side are kind of meshed together, so I'll pull them apart. And it's gonna look something like this. Here's your plastic piece, and you're gonna run it all the way down to the end. There should be some left over. Don't worry about that yet. And when you're running your finger along this, do it nice and slow, because this stuff here is sharp. So just kind of push it down, push it down, push it down. Don't just run your hand down it. You will get cut. Next, we are going to do these brackets. And the brackets look like this. They're in your bag. And you're gonna take one of them, put it on each side, or each gable piece. And this piece faces the smaller edge. Okay, just like that. Step 12, we are going to put the gables on the front and the rear. And then attach a gable brace and the track supports. So, here, you can see here in the back, if I can see. This is the rear one. We put a screw and a washer right here. Screw and a washer right here. Then there, and here, and here. This one here is at the end of the gable. And we're gonna put a screw, a washer, and a bolt in there. I don't know if it requires a washer or not, but we're gonna put it in anyway for us. This is 6635. And I only seem to have one of them, although you're supposed to have two. And you just put that on one side. Put a bolt down here for now. I'm sure it'll bolt up here as well later on. Then again, a bolt and a nut there. And then screw all of these in all the way down. That's for the rear. For the front, we are going to take these metal brackets here, and we are going to put them into, after we put this whole gable piece on here, we're going to screw in here and here, and those tap through, and the same thing on this side, and we're going to bolt this piece and in the back here as well. Step 13, we are going to put the roof beams in, and we are going to basically take this one here that we put together a long time ago, spread those two pieces apart, and jam it into that, and then bolt it in, and then the single ones get bolted onto here. When you're done, it's going to look a little something like this. You can see right here is that centerpiece. This fit nicely into it. We put bolts here and here, and the nuts on the other side. We on here put the curved side facing the wall, and put the bolts on that side, nuts on this side. And one thing you want to, same thing on that side over there. So these parts are facing inward. But the thing you want to notice, see all those little holes there? You're gonna need those for the roof. So make sure that they are on the top, because the bottom has no holes, which you really can't see because of lighting, but trust me, there's no holes there. Now to put the roof on. Step 14, we are going to start putting the roof on. You can see each of these panels here have a number on it. That is 6640. We have 6529, 6641, and so on. So you can see that we have 6529 is on here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. We have 6640 in the corners, and 6641 in the opposite corners. This is telling us to start with the back right corner, so we will do that now. I now have the right and the left rear panels on, and those are number 6640 and 6641. Let me show you what I did. First off, I started by putting these screws here in, and I put them in kind of loose so I can move some stuff around. Put all of those in, and then I did the sides. In the instructions, it says to remove this plastic piece that we just stuck on, And I don't really understand that. But you do have to lift it up some to be able to get the screw or the bolt to go all the way through to this side. Sometimes it won't want to come all the way through. So without the washer on, I'd put the nut on and try to tighten it up and then loosen the nut, put the washer on, and then screw this back on. Another problem I had was getting this here to line up. And the way I fixed that was I came down here to this corner and kind of pushed the whole shed until it lined upright. Don't forget to put these four middle screws in because you won't be able to reach them later on. The ones down on the bottom, we're gonna save for the trim. Sorry guys, I got cooking along and forgot that I was making a video. That's what happens when you get some of that metallic and Mountain Dew in you. But let's catch you up on where we're at. Okay, so step 15 is basically put more of these on and then put the weather stripping on and then put the this jobber here covering the weather stripping. I found it easier, especially since I'm doing it by myself, to do that whole side and then come back and do this side. And I also found it easier that when I'm putting these in, to do this middle row first. I did have a little bit of a hiccup on putting this on this left side because it's kind of flipped. Each one of these has, let's see if I can see something here. Well, there's one of these sides here that are flat, and that goes over top of the ribbed side. And you can see in here, there's just a little bit of a dent right on that guy right there. And then the other side's flat like this. Here's another one here you could probably see better. See how this one here is kind of dipped in? And then that makes it to where this can cover over it. Well, when I was coming back from that side, I had it facing the way that I've been doing this whole side over here. And the row with the screws on it was like here. So I had to flip this around. And now I'm lifting up, say like the next piece, I'll lift up this side, tuck the new one underneath it with the rib side underneath, and then put it down. The other thing is this guy right here, especially since doing it by yourself, it's kind of, I can barely reach it here, which means that I can't reach it on both sides at the same time. So what I do is I put the bolt in and the washer in, and then I set it down. So I'll put the bolt and the washer in here. I'll bring the other piece and slide it up here. I'll lift this up and try to line up those holes. And when I get it lined up, then I'll just kind of leave it alone. I'll grab my drill and put the battery, the weight, right on top of that screw to hold it down. And then I'll sneak up underneath here and do it finger tight. We get in there? Go ahead, there you go. I'll get the bolt or the nut here finger tight. And then I'll put a pair of like a vice grips or something like that on there. Go up top and really slowly try to screw it in. If it doesn't, I'll wait until family gets home and then have them stand under here with some catalogs with the vice grips or something until I can screw them in. Now for this weather stripping kind of stuff, this is almost like actual duct tape. It's got the metallic side and it's got this other side here with like a, I don't know, wax paper or something on it. And this side here is sticky. So I read forward in the instructions a bit and it said cut off the remaining amount, so that leads me to believe that there will be some remaining. So we're just going to put it all the way down every crevice that we can, pulling this out along the way. And don't worry if you kind of get off-centered with it, because you can always just cut it and start again. Okay, it's a lot easier with two hands, but I'm gonna show you guys at least one of these ribs with it. You can see, like, here is starting to get all off-centered. But if it rips, like it does here, you just take another piece and just right there, and it'll be good to go again. Okay, so when we get up here, I put it all the way down to the edge, lift it up, and over. So it's got a complete seal throughout the whole thing. So we are putting on the rest of these panels here for this, and I will get back to you when I get down to the end. After you get the weather stripping down, you're going to want to, in each section, put on that cover. This one is 6869. Yeah, 6869. Basically, there's two of these that are really long and one of these that are really short. The long ones go on the outsides. The shorter one goes right after that, right here, and then another long one. You can see here, I pushed down and cut off the tape. Screw these in. These are actually bolts, a washer, and a nut on the other side. It's a pretty open, you're not gonna miss the hole. It's just really tight fingering, especially if you have big manly hands like me, to get in to put the bolt in there. It's not fun. Especially when you're doing the middle ones, and if you're by yourself. If you have a partner, have somebody sit there and push this down, and then you can get the bolt on or the nut on pretty well. I still have to do that last one down there, those two, and then I'll put the rest of the roof on and the rest of these on. I'll just put the new tape, start it right here, and run it down the rest of the line. So I will let you know when we have the roof on and what happens next. When you're putting this top piece on, only do those two screws there and the two down at the very end. Don't do these yet, because the middle piece here has to overlap it. So I take my screws out and then I'm gonna have to put them back in. So I guess the same goes for here, because this is gonna have to overlap the next piece. Now that you have your roof completely put on, we're going to put this little end cap here on, as it says in step 17, and that is the ridge cap 6869. Basically, just push this through, bolt, washer, and a nut, if you can see it. After you have your cap on, we are going to put all of these screws and washers along both sides of our thing. They go right here into this hole, right here, all the way down the whole thing. These holes here on this very outer edge, that's for the next step, which are putting these on. So don't do those, just these middle ones like this. Now you should have all of these screws here put in. Next, we're going to take these pieces here. This is 6014, and that is 6015. That's the longer one. Put the longer one there, the other longer one here, and this one in the middle. And it's going to basically line up with that hole, and there's another screw hole in there. One thing I forgot when I was putting those on is to put these end caps on. So this screw, or the screw goes through that hole right there, and then through, come on, focus, and then through there. Now, one thing that I didn't see anywhere in the instructions is to put the bolts through the edge there, like we did on this side. So we'll tackle that after we're done with this trim. At this point, your shed should look something like this. So we go to step number 19, which is the door assembly, and that is what we have to do. It looks pretty complicated, but there's really only like five pieces that have to be done on this. So let's go ahead and show you what to do. First off, you're going to need one of these. It's a door handle. You're going to need a bolt and a washer and a nut, which is right there. You're going to need to find this guy right here, and this is number, I don't know if you can see this or not, I'll just tell you, it is 3719. Okay, this is going to go basically here. The door handle is going to go on the other side. You have this long piece here, which is like a center brace, and you have this piece that's going to go up here, and another one that's going to go down there. Now it says to put the gripper like this, facing the inside of the door, and put one bolt in and one nut on and tighten it loosely so we can turn this thing and play with it again in a minute. The next few steps here is just a lot of words for taking a screw and a washer and putting them right here in the center. Hold it on there with like your drill or your screwdriver. Then line this hole here up with the screw. Then line that little hole up with the screw and screw it in. After you have that done, screw in that guy, screw in this guy, and then put a second bolt right here for the handle. Now we're down to this step here. A couple things to note. You see this little guy right here? That is part of this brace here. There's a little gap right underneath here, and you want to push that into this part of the door. Okay. Next is that this one here, this is the inside of the door, and that's the outside of the door. So this little foot here, right here, has a little bit of a nub here and a lot that comes out here with that little kind of angle right there. See that? So that's how that goes in. This is on top. This is on the bottom, or vice versa, depending on how you're looking at your door. And then we put bolt, washer, nut, and then this in between it. Same thing for the middle right here. That piece here, and this piece here, and the door all go together. And then the opposite over here. On the other side, it's gonna look like this. So you can see how this ridge here goes into the door. And then we have our nuts and our washers, or our bolts and our washers, right there. Do that for this side down here, and then we will do something up there. On the top part, remember to only put a bolt and a nut right through this middle piece. Leave these side pieces here for the slide for the door. Now we have both doors assembled, and as you can see, I am missing a second piece. So I just put the handle on without that brace. But for something this big with all these parts and only missing two pieces so far, that's not really too bad. So let's hang these doors now. When it comes time to hang the door, you're going to put your door in, handle facing the outside, or the middle, and the black pieces on the bottom. You're going to come up here to the top, and you see these two holes here on the right and two holes on the left. You're going to take these big black screws that have been sitting in the bag forever, and you're going to put them into the middle of that. Now you can choose the top ones or the lower ones. I'm going to use the middle ones just because, well, it's the middle. So This goes. This there, and then onto there like that. Now that your doors are on, you might want to loosen up these screws here a little bit, because if they're too tight, then it won't slide. Also, if you're getting jammed up by, let's find one here. But like these screws underneath here, go on the outside and loosen them up just a little bit. You're gonna get a little bit of play with them though. You see here, I can just move that washer around. But these are a little too long and they block that door sometimes. So just keep adjusting it until it's right. Basically, this one, and this one are gonna be your four troublemakers. So, there is the storage unit, all shiny and done. I don't know, I think we did an okay job. Well, that's all I have for this video. As always, don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, check us out on the website, and we'll see you guys on the next one.